When it comes time to set the targeting criteria for your pay-per-click ads, does your brain kind of explode a little? I totally get it. It's a really common problem because a lot of the teachers in my industry like to tell you that what you need to do to, you know, do your market research and get clear on your brand and all this stuff is have a really clear, specific, detailed picture of what we call your ideal client avatar. So as you nail this down, we tell you things like you have to know what kind of car she drives and what kind of credit card she uses and what store she shops at. And so then you get the impression that what you need to do when you go to target your ads is put all of those targeting criteria into the platform. Let's say you're running Facebook ads, you need to put all that criteria in front of Facebook, which of course is going to totally mess up your ads because that's actually not the right way to go about it 9 times out of 10. So what is the right way to go about it? Let's talk about that, shall we? I like to put possible targeting criteria into two possible categories. You've got your arbitrary targeting and you've got your bare minimum targeting. Your arbitrary targeting, those are like the targeting criteria that you think would be nice. Like it would be really nice if my people had a lot of money or if they did a lot of, you know, shopping online with a particular, like if they had an iPhone, and you know, we get really excited about all the options that are available to us. But the issue with targeting that way is that what you're going to do is you're going to make it so difficult for Facebook or whatever platform to find these people that your costs are actually going to end up being quite higher, and you're not necessarily going to get this perfect customer that you think you're going to attract by using these criteria. When you take a more bare minimum targeting approach, on the other hand, what you do is you give the algorithm the freedom to find the people who are going to respond best to the thing you're putting in front of them. And it's not always, in fact, it's almost never the people that you expect it to be. And that's okay. Because what you're looking for in the beginning is just, you just want to get the ball rolling, right? You don't necessarily need to attract this perfect person because you might not even really know all that much about them yet. I mean, you might know who you want them to be, but who you want them to be often ends up being quite different from who they actually are. That's why when I work with clients on their ad strategy, what I encourage them to do is think about what criteria does this person have to fit? Do they have to be female? Do they have to be parents? Do they have to have an interest in this particular type of content or this particular subject matter? And that's it. That's it. We don't get super nitty gritty. We don't get super granular because the more granular you get, again, the less flexibility you allow for this stuff to really kind of work its own magic for you and on your content. Another way to think about this is what my friends over at Digital Marketer like to call the "but no one else would" strategy. This "but no one else would" thing really just comes down to what can we target that would draw out only the people who I really, really want. So in this case, you know, they like to use the example of golfers. So the way they explain it is if we want to sell a golf product, we want to make sure that the people who we attract are really legit, like into golf. So in that case, their bare minimum targeting, it wouldn't necessarily be the right way to go to select an interest group that likes maybe Tiger Woods. Because for this example, a lot of people might like Tiger Woods just because he's a celebrity, not necessarily because they're really into golf, right? So what they want to do is they want to pick a golf name that nobody else would know, that only serious golfers would know. And I really like that as a targeting strategy because you do want to keep it somewhat broad, but you also want to be specific enough that you're not pulling in people who your stuff isn't going to be relevant to. Now, of course, if and when we end up working together, we can get a whole lot more advanced. We can talk about lookalike audiences, we can talk about retargeting, all that fun stuff. But for now, that's all you need to know to get started. Just think of the bare minimum. Start with that and let me know how it goes. And of course, as always, if you'd like a little help from me making this stuff work in your business and more, then go ahead and visit brittanybullen.com/chat or click the button below and we will get started ASAP. Until then, you stay nerdy. I'm Brittany Bullen and this is how you sell more stuff.